Namaskar. It is ironical that while we focus very much on viruses and other attacks and other problems, there is one epidemic which has been raging this earth for quite some time. And since it is very, very prevalent, we don't even bother about it. I'm talking about our obesity, extra weight that we put on. It is strange that at the moment, maybe 1 billion people are suffering because they do not have enough to eat, but then there are more than 2 billion who are suffering because they have too much to eat. They're too fat for their own comfort. And you can see this change all around you. Have you noticed that it is almost impossible to find a person at the right weight once he is past 35? They are all on the excessive weight side. And if some people are at the normal weight, that may be because they've got some disease like diabetes. And we have started this trend very early. If you remember your situation even 25 years ago, hardly one or two boys in a school would be fat. But today, if you stand at the front gate of any school, any good school, and you see children coming back after the school is over, you will find that maybe 50%, if not more, children are on the obese side. And since it is becoming so common, we don't even notice that this is an issue. Why do we let it happen? For the simple reason, because we don't take it too seriously. We take it only as a cosmetic problem. Actually, it is very serious and it is very easy to remember the situation. Please remember, extra weight is bad. And the word bad is spelled with B-A-N-D. So here B stands for blood pressure, A for arthritis, and B for diabetes. It's not a question of yes or no, it's a question of when. If you have this problems running in your family, then it will be at a very young age. But even if there's no trace of any of those diseases, you may get it little later in life, but you will definitely get it. So we should be very careful about this thing, and we should understand how badly it can affect you. Let's take a simple example. You see, when you go abroad or even in India, when you travel, say by train, if it is an overnight journey, we carry quite a bit of luggage. In international travel, they allow you 23 kilograms of suitcase. Now, supposing your suitcase doesn't have wheels and you're traveling by train and your train is on platform number 2 or 3. So you get down from your car, you have to carry your suitcase yourself. You enter the platform, climb one flight of stairs, go to the other platform and get down. With that 23 kilogram of suitcase, if you don't hire a coolie, there are great chances that by the time you reach the train, your arm would be aching. Mind you, it is a journey of only 5 or 6 minutes. And when somebody is fat, say by 20 kg or 25 kg, he is carrying that weight around the clock. His liver, his gallbladder, his heart are designed for the lower weight. By putting the extra burden of 20 kg or more on his system, he is playing havoc with it. So we have to eliminate this warning sign very, very carefully. There are specific reasons why we have put on weight. We have to admit that whatever we eat has to be burnt by the body. If we eat more than what we could handle that day, all that got converted into fat and it gets stored into your fat cells. You don't make new fat cells. The old ones can grow 1,000 times more than their normal size. So they are only accommodating the food in quantity which you shouldn't have. So your first line of defense is that you should cut down the intake of food. Your portion size should be much smaller. If necessary, you can eat again after some time if you feel hungry, but do not have big meals. Big meals big meals become big trouble. So be very particular on that count. But even if you're eating the right quantity and it is the wrong kind of food, that will also have an impact on your health. We eat food which is very difficult to digest. Meat, eggs, cheese, they all fall under condensed food category. So keep them off as much as possible. Our body is a strange machine. It is designed to live on live food. The live foods are your fruits, veggies, and your sprouts. Basically, anything which can be stored in an airtight jar and kept in your kitchen for 10 days or more cannot be called fresh food. You should remember that we have been on this earth for more than 2.5 million years so far. And out of these, we have started growing crops and eating wheat and corn and rice and pulses only 10,000 years ago. Before that, we were entirely on fruits, veggies and nuts and seeds and sprouts. So, these were meant to be 80% of your total diet, and grain was only a supplement that could be up to 20%. Today we have totally put things upside down. Our tummy is filled with mostly the dead foods, too much of roti and too much of bread. So be careful on that count. At the same time, also be careful about what foods you are eating. Certain foods are very easy to digest while others are very difficult to digest. So the difficult to digest foods will always pad you up. Meat falls in that category, cheese falls in the same category, and so does the eggs. So cut out on those foods which are notorious for making you fat. Those also include your refined flour. It also includes milk concentrates. It includes fat and it includes sugar also. So eat right. Right food in the right quantity. At the same time, you have to also focus on your physical activity. Our food may have come down by at best say 10%, but our physical activity has been reduced to maybe 10% of what our ancestors used to do. So you have to remain active so that some fuel can be burnt by your body itself. That will automatically reduce your weight and other serious problems. And then there is this mental block. We think that since I am huge, I need to have extra food. No. If you are in the large category, that means you have put on weight so that you can burn it off later. If you keep on eating regular food, then the body will never burn this part. So take care of this factor also. You digest your food better if you eat at a fixed time. So do not change your meal time from 11 to 12 to 1 to 2. Always start at the right time, fixed time. And in the end, you should be careful about one factor. When we don't take enough water, and the body cannot do without water, it commandeers your digestive system. It converts your thirst into food or into hunger. So that even if you eat more, the body can extract some water from your solid food. So in place of taking one shake, you will feel like having two. And if it is, say, one katori of pulses, you would like to have two, because some water can go in from there also. So be aware of these factors. Cut out your darlings seriously. Don't go for any dieting, because it has a beginning date and an ending date. Never works like that. The target should be always reasonable. My recommendation is that you eat right food in right quantity and you do your at least 1 hour of exercise, you should be able to shed 2 kilograms of weight every month. That may not appear to be too much when it is raining, but in the process of reducing, that is the crucial period, then 2 kg doesn't appear to be much. But if you look at 1 year time frame, you can lose as much as 24 kg. So just apply these simple methods. Never be going hungry. Eat small portions repeatedly. Your body will be thankful to you. Sudden weight loss always have side effects. So these are the few tips which will make it so very easy for you to shed weight. 0.5 kilo every week, 2 kilo every month. That should be your target. Here is praying that you go back to the school into the shape in which you were when you were in school or college. Thank you very much.